The cells that produce the appetite-suppressing hormone GLP-1, in response to calorie exposure, are concentrated all the way down at the end of our digestive tract, which is why our appetites are not suppressed very much these days. The majority of calories we eat are absorbed early in our digestive tract, so never make it down far enough. When we eat a donut, its fat, sugar, and starch get absorbed quickly, high up, before reaching the part of our digestive tract where we produce most of the hormone that suppresses our appetite. So, from a GLP-1 standpoint, it's like we never ate much of anything. No wonder we reach for donut number two. How can we eat a donut and still get GLP-1 activation? Surgery! Bariatric surgery can involve cutting out part of our small intestine, so some of the donut calories may reach the end of it after all. What if you want to eat a donut, still get GLP-1 activation, and keep your anatomy intact? Drugs! By injecting GLP-1 mimicking drugs like Ozempic, you can get GLP-1 activation no matter what you eat. You could also take the starch blocker drug acarbose to slow the digestion of carbohydrates, or the fat blocker drug orlistat to slow the digestion of fats. But what if you want GLP-1 activation without drugs or surgery? Well, you could try not eating donuts. Ancestral humans might have consumed as much as 100 grams of fiber daily. That's about 6 times what most of us are getting these days. We evolved eating massive amounts of whole plant foods, the only place fiber is found in abundance. So by eating the way nature intended, we can release GLP-1 the way nature intended, which helps explain why a whole food plant-based diet is one of the most powerful weight loss interventions ever published. But what do we do about our cravings? What are some therapeutic approaches to addressing them? Well, there are drugs, of course, but in terms of food-based interventions, there are thylakoids, which are just the chlorophyll-rich membranes inside leaves where photosynthesis takes place. Thylakoids act as fat blockers, delaying our digestion of fats and promoting the release of satiety hormones like GLP-1. When we eat thylakoids, in other words, when we bite into a leaf of spinach, for instance, the thylakoid membranes are able to resist our digestive enzymes. They can last for hours in our gut before finally being broken down, and it is in those hours when they work their magic. Thylakoids glom onto tiny droplets of fat in our digestive tract, and in this way powerfully slow our digestion of fat, and that means more GLP-1. Yes, GLP-1 is a hormone that's being developed as an anti-obesity drug. This was published 2 years before Ozempic. But thylakoids can cause our natural endogenous release of GLP-1, which is an easier, more physiological way to enhance GLP-1 levels to achieve satiety and calorie balance. But does it actually cut cravings? Spinach extracts were disguised in jam and juice to sneak thylakoids undetected into meals. And those unwittingly eating the equivalent of about a half a cup of cooked spinach felt significantly less hungry and more satiated over the next few hours. Give someone the equivalent of a shot of wheatgrass juice or what they might get in a green drink or green smoothie, and not only do they feel more satiated, but their cravings for sweet, salty, and fatty snacks, such as potato chips, chocolate, and cinnamon buns, drop by about a third. Feed them candy anyway, and those who unknowingly have been snuck some spinach report liking the sweets significantly less. The satiating power of greens has been attributed to their high fiber and water contents and low-calorie density, but the thylakoids may be their secret weapon, presumably because of the increased release of GLP-1 following thylakoid supplementation. In a systematic review of randomized control trials on the effects of thylakoid intake on appetite and weight loss, hunger-suppressing effects of thylakoids were reported in all studies that directly measured hunger and fullness. But what about the weight loss? Would the GLP-1-induced reduction of cravings and hunger from greens translate into losing pounds? That's what I'll cover next.